live, Floyd Mayweather tries to make the case that he is now boxing's pound-for-pound best.
Floyd keeps pounding him with right hands.
He has swept through the junior lightweight and lightweight ranks with uncommon skill and a perfect record.
Terrific performance by Floyd Mayweather.
Tonight, he moves up to 140 pounds to face DeMarcus Chop Chop Corley. And as Floyd Mayweather eyes a string of big fights, he also seeks to answer boxing's question of the moment. If the Roy Jones pound-for-pound era is over, can Floyd Mayweather be the man to take his place? You can see that Floyd is 2 years younger, has a one-inch height advantage, and a one-and-a-half-inch arm length advantage measured from the armpit to the end of the fist against the guy who is regarded by many as a slightly bigger man because he's been in this weight class his whole career. But they both weighed in at the limit of 140 pounds, and tonight, unofficially on our HBO scale as they enter the ring, Mayweather is the bigger man by a single pound over DeMarcus Corley. Rules of the bout with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Letterman.
The Floyd Mayweather-DeMarcus Corley fight is scheduled for 12 rounds using the unified rules of the Association of Boxing Commissions. There is no three knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. In case a cut is caused by an accidental headbutt, we go to the scorecards after four rounds have been completed, and you cannot be saved by the bell in any round, including the 12th and final round. Jim!
Here comes DeMarcus Corley, the man with the gas mask on. As you can see, his last fight was almost a year ago, a disappointing outing against Zab Judah. Since that time, Larry Merchant, he sparred part of the time with Ricardo Mayorga to help Mayorga get ready for his battle against another southpaw, Corey Spinks. Prior to that, he had been sparring in Australia with Costa Zoo,
where he found the material for this costume. He does sew his things. He didn't sew this particular outfit. He wants to come in telling us he's a warrior. The important thing is he's a left-handed warrior, because in the last 6 months we've seen four upsets: Pacquiao, Moreira, last week of course with Tarver and Jones. We saw Spinks and Mayorga. We saw Winky Wright take out Shane Mosley. All southpaws causing those upsets.
Emmanuel, how big is the southpaw factor in this fight tonight, given that one of Floyd Mayweather's best punches is his straight right hand?
Well, that can normally be a great asset for a good right hand puncher, but in this particular case, the fact that Floyd has not fought that many southpaws, in fact I understand only one, and that was early in his career, it could be an advantage for Marcos Colac. If he gets away from Floyd's straight right hand, he has a great advantage, but that is Floyd's main weapon.
Corley's plan for the fight is to try to pressure Floyd Mayweather Jr. That could make for some entertainment. There is notable wins. He beat a huge right-hand puncher, but a one-dimensional fighter in Randall Bailey. He also defeated Bailey's conqueror in Air Julio twice. The loss to Zab Judah, his most disappointing outing, as he feels and many others feel, he didn't put his best fight into the ring that night. And perhaps he's wearing the gas mask because he said that fabric had a gamey smell. Now here's Floyd Mayweather, who in his last fight against Filipendo in his hometown of Grand Rapids, Michigan, produced, Larry, his most impressive offensive performance.
It was a virtuoso performance, but still he has not been able to turn that into box office appeal. We have a few thousand fans who wandered off the boardwalk into the arena tonight. He thinks his face should be on billboards in Times Square. He thinks he should get paid more than anybody else. But for whatever reason, including the fact that he has a police rap sheet almost as long as his boxing record, he has never been able to capitalize on his magic in the ring.
Massive distractions outside the ring. He's facing scheduled court dates in both Nevada and Michigan, either one of which could, if it goes the wrong way, could conceivably put him into the big house for at least a short period of time. But he says it's all hearsay, nothing bad will happen, the cases will be dismissed, and he'll go on from there. We shall see. For now, let's go to ring announcer Michael Buffer for the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, by way of Atlantic City's famous Boardwalk Hall, Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, in association with Caesars Entertainment, is proud to present 12 rounds of boxing in the super lightweight division. On the line, the WBC number one world ranking. This contest is sponsored by the undisputed king of beers, Budweiser, and sanctioned by the New Jersey State Athletic Control Board Boxing Commissioner, Larry Hazard Sr. The three judges at ringside, scoring this bout on the 10-point system will be William Boudou, Milvina Lathan, and Gail Van Oy. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Benji Esteves Jr. And now for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, with dedication to the men and women now serving in the armed forces of the United States of America, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing camouflage, his official weight, 140 pounds. His professional record, 28 victories, including 16 knockouts, with only two and a draw. From our nation's capital, Washington, D.C., here is the former WBO junior welterweight champion of the world, DeMarcus Chop Chop Corley. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black with white, his official weight also 140 pounds. His professional record, a perfect one, 31 bouts, 31 victories, including 21 knockouts. He is the pride of Grand Rapids, Michigan, the former lightweight champion of the world, former junior lightweight champion of the world, the undefeated pretty boy, Floyd Mayweather.
Okay, DeMarcus, Floyd, again, pay my commands. Protect yourself at all times. Good luck to both of you. May the best man win. Touch him up.
After Mayweather's only experience with a southpaw, actually a conventional fighter who turned southpaw, his father, Floyd Mayweather Sr., called from prison to tell his handlers, don't ever put him in with a southpaw again. This is the first time since that time he has faced a southpaw.
Round one begins, and we'll see if Corley lives up to his stated goal of pressuring Mayweather and trying to make Floyd fight 3 minutes of every round, which he says other opponents have failed to do.
Yeah, Corley said that he's going to put pressure on Floyd instead of laying back trying to box like most of the guys that he's fought in the past.
Well, it certainly makes sense, because I think boxing Floyd Mayweather is, for most fighters, going to be suicide. The question is it Corley's game to do this?
Well, you know, Floyd's biggest punch basically is his right hand. If Corley can get away from the right hand, he'll neutralize his biggest asset. And I'll be honest with you, I think that the most important punch at this stage has been the right hand from Corley.
Corley trying to work behind his jab and move forward on Mayweather. Mayweather brought the crowd out of their seats with a big body shot that drove Corley into the ropes.
Good punch to the body by Mayweather.
Good weapon against the southpaw. Mayweather making clear that he expects to be able to use his jab against the southpaw, DeMarcus Corley, and then steps forward and hits Corley with a straight right hand and another.
It's interesting to note that both of these guys have very good amateur backgrounds. The fact they was often in the amateur tournaments together, only at that time Mayweather was fighting about 106 pounds when Corley was always close to 140 pounds.
Corley pressuring Mayweather into the corner, and landing the back half of the big 1-2. Corley's trained for the first time tonight, Emmanuel, by Don Turner. You know him so well from your days of training Lennox Lewis against him when he was training Evander Holyfield. What might Don do to change Corley, if at all?
Well, Don Turner is one of the good veteran fighters. In fact, Don used to work with the Kronk boxing team. He's one of our trainers in the late 80s. Don has been putting a lot of time on telling Corley to keep a lot of pressure on him and basically not let him have that time to rest like most of the guys have had him let him do. And at this stage, I will be very honest with you, this is turning out to be one of the most competitive rounds that I've ever saw Floyd Mayweather have as a professional fighter.
Absolutely. He has indeed been physically challenged by Corley in the round.
And Corley's right jab over the shoulder of Mayweather has been very effective at this stage.
But Mayweather has also managed to land his straight right a couple times and stuns Corley with a straight right right under the jaw.
Mayweather switched up now and is fighting left-handed and right-handed.
So much skill.
One of the biggest assets of any boxer or any athlete is speed, and he has tremendous speed. Even when you do things wrong and you have good speech, you still get away with it often.
Last week, Buddy McGirt, trainer of Antonio Tarver, said to Larry Merchant, the way to stop speed is to go right at it. That's what Corley's trying to do, and he hits Mayweather with a roundhouse right to punctuate a highly competitive round one.
You want to hit him easy and go the other way, all right? Go the other way. Easy work. It's going to be easier when you all try to stand in front of him. Okay. You keep walking right in front of the left hand. Go the other way. Keep training. Keep that to the body. Keep that.
You got to fight him, champ.
You see how far his legs is apart, man?
Close your ass and listen.
Come in behind a jab, a double jab.
Here's Mayweather. It was actually a punch to the body that sent Corley off balance. Corley believes he's as strong or stronger than Mayweather, and he's going to try to stay in his chest.
Pretty high up on the body, that punch actually landed around the clavicle. And interestingly, in round one, Mayweather launched 27 power punches by copy box count, but Corley threw 28 back. However, Mayweather landing at a higher frequency rate and landed a good-sized left hook there.
Well, it's hard to beat activity, and Mayweather's been very active considering Corley only had one major fight, I guess, for the last year. And activity is a big, big factor, especially when you're in these small weight divisions. And speed is such a big factor.
Straight right hand, Mayweather popping Corley right on the chin. On the other hand, Corley trained for 6 weeks with Pastazu, certainly the biggest right-hand puncher in the 140-pound weight class. So Floyd Mayweather's right hand shouldn't be too heavy for him.
Well, I think different. I think speed is a bigger factor because Pastazu is a good right hand, but it's just a power right hand. But Mayweather has so much speed, and that's the biggest factor.
And he's landing his right hand, and now Corley lands a right hand straight up the middle. The momentarily back Mayweather off, but Floyd comes right back and pressures Corley to the ropes, lands two good body shots. Excellent body punching earlier here tonight by Floyd Mayweather.
Well, you know, I never expected this type of a fight. I thought it was going to be a technical fight, but it's turning out to be a brawl for the most part.
They're going to stand and trade shots, at least for the moment. And obviously, this is part of the arrogance of Floyd Mayweather, who could use his boxing skills, but believes, obviously, that he's got enough power to stand and trade shots with a 140-pound fighter in his first trip to this weight class.
In particular, Chop Chop said that he wanted to make it a physical fight, and that's what he's got, but Mayweather seemed to have the better of it because of the speed. Also, I could point out that about a year or so ago, I know Mayweather was having a lot of problems with his hands, and that was a reason I think a lot of his fights, he was fighting so defensive. Recently, his hands is healed up by him merely taking time off and letting them heal properly, and that's been, I think, the result of him having so much more confidence now.
Certainly his hands weren't hurting against Ndo as he unloaded power shot after power shot, fighting in the pocket.
When Mayweather's friend Zab Judah was fighting Corley, Mayweather was sitting in the audience urging Judah to become more offensive, to come right at Corley. And he is more offensive tonight.
He's much more confident too.
All right, shots by Mayweather. Corley comes back with his own fierce body shot.
I think Zab Judah and Mayweather's relationship goes back to they were amateur teammates in the Olympics in 1996. And now he's talking about fighting Zab Judah.
Actually, they were together at the Olympic trials. Judah, you'll recall, didn't make the Olympic team in the 86.
Good left by Corley, right on the jaw. Mayweather took it well.
Having been upset by David Diaz in the trials. What an entertaining fight.
Very entertaining, surprisingly to me.
To his right. Keep taking them both ways, okay?
Fight and speaking of entertaining, each Friday night catch On the Record with Bob Costas. Next week's guests include a musical performance by Avril Lavigne and the star of the upcoming movie The Day After Tomorrow, Dennis Quaid.
Right. But listen, that way he gets a chance to get back. Fuck him. Let him earn it. Don't let him hit the shit. You keep punching him down. You keep touching him down. You doing what you're doing. That's what makes the work easy.
Come on.
You're waiting too long.
Corley's going to have to land more of these to send Mayweather off of him. To convince Mayweather there's no profit in standing toe-to-toe.
Mayweather with excellent power-punching numbers via CompuBox in the first two rounds.
There is
44%.
There is a bit of a welt under the right eye of Mayweather, perhaps from that punch in the late stages of the last round.
I'm very impressed with Mayweather's performance at this stage. He's standing toe-to-toe. He's out fighting Corley. He's not trying to outbox him. And he hasn't went into that shoulder roll where he gets very defensive a lot. Tonight he's very effective, again, offensive.
And not bothered at all by facing a southpaw, but this southpaw is coming forward, which takes some of the advantage off of being left-handed.
Mayweather very calm. Amid the eye of the storm as Corley continues to try to put pressure on him, coming at him.
Maybe some blood in Corley's nose.
Mayweather's taking the role of the aggressive fighter in the fight.
Trying to block Corley's shots and pick him off and then retaliate immediately from close range. Another good right hand by Floyd Mayweather inside. Corley is indeed an entirely different fighter tonight than the man who fought Zab Judah last summer. Far more of a commitment to the fight. Can't seem to stop Floyd Mayweather's straight right hand.
Mayweather's starting to be affected with the punch that he was depending on the most, which was the straight right hand. That's going to be a big factor going down the stretch if he can continue to land that punch. I don't think Corley was expecting Mayweather to be this aggressive himself. He thought Mayweather would be running back and he would be aggressive. But the roles have been reversed.
Here's a big left hand by Corley, momentarily stuns Mayweather.
It hurt Mayweather too.
Mayweather grins, fires back two body shots, but make no mistake, he was stunned by the left hand.
All right, keep him up. Let's go.
Mayweather has shaken it off and goes back after Corley with that right hand of his. Body shots by Mayweather, Corley coming with uppercuts.
All right, let him out. Keep your head up. All right, break, clean. Keep it clean, guys.
Round three, a little bit more troublesome round than the first two were for Floyd Mayweather, largely because of the one big left-hand shot that seemed to blunt Mayweather's offense down the stretch.
I think he's got his bearings back together now, though. But it's interesting, even after he got it hit.
Now, this was a really hard punch with a left hand. Mayweather took the punch, but it gave him some notice that he can't be completely reckless in his aggressiveness.
Close your eyes and listen to what they say.
You had him hurt, Chopper, you let him get away. Get up on him. Make him fight. He don't want to fight. He want to sit outside and pick shots. Make him fight, man. Fight this motherfucker. Fight him.
Oh, you're beautiful.
You keep taking him to his right. Okay. That's all the fuck you need to do.
Keep breaking him down. Keep breaking him down.
You're going to get him out of there anyway.
You're going to pop it up anyway. You're going to pop it up anyway. You got the poppy? Yeah.
All right, let's go.
How you feel?
Come on, boy!
Copy of box numbers through the third round. Mayweather 55 out of 152. Corley 31 out of 160. Harold Letterman, how do you have it through three?
Okay, Jim. 3-0, 30-27. Floyd Mayweather.
Well, he's in trouble now as DeMarcus Corley once again catches him and now tries to go to work against the ropes.
A right hand sent Mayweather back into the ropes.
And now Corley working against a Mayweather who's leaning back against the ropes, trying to get in something good to the body as Mayweather tries to fend him off while leaning back.
Well, one thing I'll give Corley credit for, he's trying to take his time, not throwing up too many punches where he drains himself, trying to wait for a good clean punch.
Corley not over anxious, Mayweather gathering himself and coming back. Now he tries to stop Corley's offense with body shots of his own.
Mayweather's hurt, but he's still fighting back.
Great left hook by Mayweather. Now Corley's hurt.
There's an opportunity for Corley here if he can take it, because as you just said, he is hurt. I think both fighters are hurt here.
Yeah, there's an opportunity for Mayweather too.
And we're only about halfway through the round.
Trading shots at close range. Suddenly it's Batty Ward 4 in a... in a pairing where we never expected to see it.
But Mayweather's very good with those little short punches in close like this here. Whereas Corley has to get a little bit more swing room for him.
Right hand by Mayweather. Hardest punch of the fight. Corley, visibly stunned by that one. Trying to duck and slip. Catches another big right hand. And down goes Corley to his knee. Two solid right hand shots by Floyd Mayweather.
No, he ruled it not a knockdown. He went down of his own accord.
That's stunning to me because I thought he went down to stop the assault.
This
but in the scoring of the fight, it won't be a knockdown. And Mayweather grinned over at us as if to say, what a fight. And now Corley's back on him and landing big shots.
I never expected this. But you know, the way it's going, I don't think it's going to go to 12 rounds.
Hard right hands by Corley. Two in a row. Mayweather took him very well. Going back with his own shots. Big drama in Atlantic City. Floyd Mayweather trying to supplant Roy Jones atop the pound-for-pound list and playing a game of Russian roulette with DeMarcus Corley. There's blood coming from Floyd's nose. There's blood coming from Corley's nose and mouth. That was a big right hand, and Corley took it reasonably well. Comes back with some body shots of his own. What a fourth round.
5 seconds.
That's the highest contact round of Floyd Mayweather's entire 32-fight career.
That was a good, good, exciting round, but if I had to put my money at this point in time, I'd still go with Mayweather.
All right. Fight smart. Don't worry about trying to bang with the motherfucker. Fight smart. He already hurt.
Yeah.
Floyd, listen. Don't worry about trying to kick
him
up.
Dinner right. Yes. Dinner right,
Chop. Give me some basketball.
Yeah.
He is tired. He's tired, Chop. Next time you hurt him, change speeds and jump on his ass. You want this fight?
This is a fierce round. Give Corley credit. That right hand stunned Mayweather. And now give Mayweather credit for pulling himself together to take control later. And there was another, a left-hand shot. Mayweather hoarding his strength. Looked like he came out the stronger fighter at the end of the last round.
Indeed, he ran to his corner after all that and seemed anxious to get back in there. Whereas Corley looked a little weary in his corner between rounds 4 and 5. Mayweather Mayweather definitely the pressure fighter now in round five.
Yeah, it seems to have David to think better under these kind of conditions, which is interesting. But, you know, he's been a more active fighter as compared to Corley, and that makes a big difference.
Switches to a southpaw stance, lands a vicious left hand, goes back at Corley with two more shots to the body. Floyd Mayweather fighting all the way tonight. Straight right hand again landed flush.
Most fighters who have the kind of quickness that Mayweather has are content to stay outside and use their speed advantage.
Well, I think he wanted to make a point tonight. He came here to really prove that he's the best pound-for-pound fighter. He wanted to look impressive tonight, even at the risk of possibly being knocked out.
Let him out. We have to remember that Corley is about the eighth or ninth ranked junior welterweight. He's not one of the elite junior welterweights, but he's fighting very tough here tonight.
Well, few fighters have as much incentive as DeMarcus Corley. He must feed his own seven children and the seven children of his deceased brother Michael.
And he's making about 5% of what Mayweather is making tonight. Mayweather making over $3 million, Corley $150,000, and Corley is fighting as hungry as a fighter can fight.
Step back.
Great body shot by Mayweather. Sets up a right hand that stuns Corley again. DeMarcus Corley again hurt. Gets in one right hand off the ropes. Mayweather trying to finish it right now.
But you know, Marcus comes back with these shots when you least expect to. Even though Mayweather's landed very good, he's still got to be awful alert and being very careful all the time still.
Corley showing courage and stick-to-itiveness against a guy who's whacking him repeatedly with the right hand. And DeMarcus Corley, to his credit, still chasing.
Yes.
Oh, look at the brilliant body shot. Right hand by Mayweather nearly folded Corley up.
It folded him up because it was low.
I thought it was right on the belt line.
Well, the referee didn't.
Well, the referee didn't think that was a knockdown 2 rounds ago.
Don't get caught with it. Keep using the jab. Keep the right hook in there, okay? Deep breath. Now, listen. Boxing.
Okay.
You punching his ass anyway. You gonna get his ass down the stretch. The fight ain't in one round, 2 rounds.
Too much talent. Okay.
Don't worry about that.
Watch
handle
it.
Your business.
Okay.
Floyd.
Yeah.
Keep fighting.
You wanted more than him, champ.
We've been champ before.
Time for them to change over, champ.
All right.
Come on, man. Let's go. When you get inside, remember, hard uppercut.
He's trying to whip.
He's trying to whip.
Is Mayweather lining up his right hand? That is not a real hard punch. It's not a punch that was thrown with his body behind it, but it was an effective punch.
Well, most of his right hands are more arm punches than body punches, but he's so quick with them that the effect is devastating anyway. Mayweather, 23 out of 56 by CompuBox count in round five, and as you can see, he has so far won every round on Harold Letterman's scorecard. Mayweather from a southpaw stance where he's been effective throwing power punches.
Mayweather got instructions from his corner.
Again, it's not a knockdown, despite the fact that Mayweather landed a left hand.
Roger Mayweather, his trainer, instructed him to box this round.
That's a question that I wanted to ask Emmanuel. Can a fighter go back to boxing after committing himself to this kind of a brawl for five rounds?
Once you get in the rhythm of a war like that, it's very hard to get out of that. You know, it gets in your blood, and you can't change up. But at this stage here, the fight can go either way, because Corley is still throwing hard punches when he does punch. He has no power is went out of his punches. So Mayweather just seems to be a little sharper, a little bit more comfortable in there, probably because of the activity level. But nevertheless, anything can happen in this fight.
Mayweather is going back to throwing his jab, which had been missing for a couple of rounds. Great right hand.
Well, his mindset is to fight tonight. I don't think he wants to box. Even if he could win the fight easy by boxing, I don't think that's what he wants to do.
I agree. I think he's here to put on a show. And what a show it's been so far. A risky one, though. Floyd with a grin on his face as Corley corners in.
I got you. Okay, let him out.
Mayweather's not punching with power now. When he throws his right hand, it's more just like a right jab. I don't know whether it's because maybe he's just trying to go for the punch right now, or maybe his right hand's been hurt.
Could be one of the reasons that Uncle Roger, his trainer, told him to go back to boxing.
Yeah, because he's not punching that much with power.
If the hands are hurt, he won't be able to fight the same fight he's fought up to this point. Or it would seem unlikely, and now Mayweather begins to back away from Corley's assaults.
But Mayweather's very good at that, landing the ropes and rolling the shoulders and turning around. That's something he masters.
Oh, don't hold the rope. That's twice. Come on, let's go.
Stev is warning Corley not to hold the ropes and try to box Mayweather in.
That's good.
Unquestionably, Floyd Mayweather has lost some of his sharpness in this round.
5 seconds.
And we're halfway through a scheduled 12-round fight still to come between this fight and the taped broadcast of Tarver Jones from last week. Oscar De La Hoya will join us live from Las Vegas. Bernard Hopkins live from Miami. We'll talk about their doubleheader coming up, HBO pay-per-view on June 5, and the possibility that those two great fighters match their records, their pride, their amazing commitment to the sport against each other this September.
Stay first. Crowd.
Yeah, good fight.
Don't stay outside. Crowd is there.
I think that's the understatement.
Very good fight. You know, everybody's figuring that Oscar doesn't have much of a chance, but I give him a very good chance.
Well, then there you go. So if you give him a very good chance, then not everyone is figuring that he doesn't have much of a chance. Because Larry gives him a good chance also.
Well, you know, Oscar's been in a lot of super fights, and he's got extremely fast hands. And he knows how to win those decisions.
And a great deal of savvy.
And a lot of guts to what he has to.
Well, he shows that, on the surface at least, just by wanting to fight Bernard Hopkins.
Keep it clean in there.
CompuBox numbers in the sixth. Mayweather 23 out of 51. Corley 10 out of 59. And Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim. 60 to 54. 6 rounds to nothing. Floyd Mayweather Jr. Jim, I got to tell you something. We talk about the 4 points which we score. Effective aggressiveness is all Floyd Mayweather because he gets off first. Clean punching, beautiful right hands. And defense, he's got that crosswise defense where he crosses his hands in front of his body and he either slips Corley's punches or blocks them.
At this stage right here, Floyd Mayweather seems to be mentally much more alert, much more sharper, which is a good characteristic of a lot of your great fighters. Ali was that way later in the late rounds of fights. He could think and function much better, take advantage of opportunities. And that's a great characteristic to have.
Did you just compare Floyd Mayweather Jr. to Muhammad Ali?
No, but his ability to think, I'd say, and particularly in close, using his shoulders and those short right hands, he's very good at doing that.
I'll spin. Come on. Just keep it clean.
Mayweather's punch output appears to be dropping. And that in itself has to be seen as circumstantial evidence that a fighter who has struggled throughout his career with his hands may have hand difficulties again.
That's very true.
Or it simply may be that he expended so much energy in the first 4 rounds that he's trying to take a break.
Okay, come on.
Which I think is more likely, because I haven't seen any evidence of in the corner that he's having a problem with his hands yet.
No.
Nor has he shaken it, as fighters often will do when they're experiencing pain.
It does mean this is a rougher fight than he's ever had in his career.
Let him out.
He popped Corley with the right hand as he backed into the corner, and Corley eyed him as if to say, that right hand isn't what I was tasting before. Good little right hook by Corley. Good punch in return by Mayweather. Mayweather trying to drive some body shots against him as Corley went into the ropes. Good uppercut by Mayweather. Just a little pop.
Floyd, come on. Come on, you push him through. That's twice. Come on now. Let's go.
Quick left hook inside by Mayweather. Now just touching Corley with the right hand. He goes into a southpaw stance. Chops him over the top with the left twice.
5 seconds.
Corley hadn't landed a big power punch in a couple of rounds now.
No, but he's making it a very tough fight for Mayweather. Now putting a lot of pressure on him and making him fight.
You're beating him easy. You're beating him easy. But still, put your shots together. Give me a towel. You ain't got a towel? On his head. You gotta start bringing a towel up here, man.
Now just breathe normal through your mouth. It's normal. Hold your mouth open.
Champ, you gotta pick the pace up, champ. Eighth round, champ.
You gotta pick the pace. Okay. Hold your mouth open. Let's go. Pick the pace up. Stop swinging hard at the head.
Okay.
Set him up and then hit him in the head.
Set the left hand to his chest, champ.
He want to rest. I'm saying, don't let him rest. He's caught. Just keep punching.
In round seven, CompuBox found only 9 punches landed for DeMarcus Corley. That's his lowest number so far in the fight. Still, he could change everything with one big punch.
Well, the thing about Mayweather is he's the kind of fighter who can win a round while he's resting because of his skills.
Thrown with authority again by Mayweather. 2 big pops with the right hand, and Corley backed away.
You notice all of Mayweather punches are very short and pinpoint right now. He's not wasting anything. Anything that he shoots is very short.
And if Corley isn't able to land anything big the rest of the way, point to the hard work that Mayweather did going to the body in the first 6 rounds. Mayweather switches southpaw, tries twice to land the right uppercut. Now back to the conventional stance, throws his jab. Corley's hands noticeably slower than at the beginning of the fight.
That's that elbow.
Boom! Big left hook.
I was just going to point out that Mayweather's down going into his normal style of fighting, which is using his left shoulders for all of his defensive motion, and returning little short right hand punches after making a defensive motion with his left shoulder.
And continuing to work underneath to the body of Corley. Corley lands 2 shots, but takes 2 bigger ones in return. And this time it will be called a knockdown, as amid the pressure, Corley put his knee on the canvas.
7, 8.
Wisely so. I think he was in deep trouble and decided that he needed a bit of a rest.
At this point, he can't win the fight on the scorecards anyway, or so it would appear. Save himself to try for knockout shots. What a body assault by Mayweather. Corley landed his left hand flush. Floyd walked right through it. That's the 4th time Corley's been on the canvas, and 3 of them have not been ruled knockdowns.
You fight, that's all you gotta do. Yeah. Champ, send the left hand under 1 time, champ. Believe me, it's dead. Send it under, pull the right hook.
All right.
It's dead, champ.
It works.
Around there.
Get rid of it right quick. Drink it, drink it.
But
this is okay.
Did I say baddies? You got a mustache?
You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. You got gray hair. I see that.
All right.
A pink shirt.
Good for
you.
After a couple of deliberately passive rounds, Mayweather turned it up again. And that right hand followed by the left almost was the beginning of the end. It did lead to a knockdown or a go down by Corley.
Come on, man.
Tremendous round for Mayweather. In CompuBox numbers, 33 out of 54, 61%. Brutal. Corley 13 out of 53. Mayweather continues winning every single round on Harold Letterman's scorecard. Corley came here looking to knock him out anyway.
Corley's not really a big knockout puncher to begin with. And Mayweather just surprised me a lot with him being so much more aggressive. But, you know, once again, he's been very busy fighting much better quality of opposition. And it's beginning to show.
Although there's blood around the right eye of Floyd Mayweather.
Okay, watch the elbow, both keep it clean.
The accuracy of his power punches in the last two rounds is something to behold.
That's what I was saying in the beginning. He's a very active puncher, and he's almost fully aware of everything that's going on around him. Not only in the ring, even outside of the ring sometimes.
Well, of course, it's been pointed out many times. Grew up in the fight game. His father and both of his uncles, all very good professional fighters. There's a hard right hand by Mayweather. Corley keeps coming, catches an uppercut. What a courageous effort by DeMarcus Corley, who has walked through a ton of good stuff tonight. They try to get at Floyd Mayweather Jr.
When a kid starts boxing at those ages of 5 and 7, they have just built-in instincts that happens automatically where they don't have to even think.
And that's Floyd Mayweather. He grew up in the gym.
He can feel punches coming even before they start. And he uses that shoulder roll and then little short right-hand shots after that. And it's hard for a guy to get away from that.
I got you. No.
Fifth time Corley's been on the canvas.
Come on.
Only one knockdown so far.
And whenever a fighter keeps going down for whatever reason, there slips, falls, pushes or whatever, off balance, it still is a sign that something is not right and his legs is not as strong as they should be.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Mayweather hadn't been on the canvas a single time. Corley's been there 5 times.
The right hand leads are becoming effective.
And Corley's able to land his left flush from time to time, but there's just no snap on it anymore.
No. He's working when he throws his punches, but Mayweather's is more pinpoint, much more accurate, knows where they're going, and you're going to see more and more right-hand leads coming continually as the fight goes on.
There's a good, quick left hook by Floyd Mayweather. Corley steps inside. Just trying to get his hands on Floyd at this point.
And when he does, Floyd just gives him a lot of shoulders, that's all. Very seldom can get an effective punch off of him.
Corley lands his left hand a couple of times.
Floyd's going to shoot a short right hand. Oh, my God.
Like Roy Jones, I could. We ain't trying to do that shit.
Okay.
He got to earn it. He ain't got his ass before already now. You the ball.
We're taking him in deep and we're going to drown him.
Floyd. This
night, bro?
Yeah. How you feel?
Championship round.
Floyd. Same we're going to do now.
Okay.
Keep staying close to him. Box it.
Okay. Good
white guy. Hit on his ass, man.
Larry Merchant, let's look at a package of Floyd Mayweather right hands through the course of the evening.
Sometimes he lets it go from the shoulder with mean intentions. Sometimes he just shoots it out. His quickness, that kind of a right hand is sort of a half jab. But he has a lot of weapons in his arsenal.
And again, to repeat the point that Emmanuel has made several times, such remarkable accuracy on his punches. Left hook floors Corley. Right in the center of the ring.
Everything was short. He just locked his arms up and twisted the punches off. Never had to reach and throw anything wide.
Perfect craft. and perfect technique.
And Corley couldn't see the punch because they were so short.
Second time Corley's been down official. Sixth time he's been on the canvas.
Don't forget, Corley's never been stopped in a fight, I don't think, amateur or professional.
Doesn't want to be here. When you say amateur, DeMarcus Corley had 119 amateur fights, 101 wins, 17 losses. That's a pretty good amateur career.
Very good. He was a good bout, but very good amateur. He was on the Washington, D.C. scene, and often in tournaments, going down the stretch for the team titles. Mayweather, which was on the Michigan and the Detroit team, and the Washington team, so they know each other from the amateurs, only they was in different weight divisions.
Floyd Mayweather lost in the 1996 Atlanta Olympics to Serafin Todorov of Bulgaria, the fighter who was favored to win his weight class. Mayweather says that was a scoring failure. Of course, in his view, he's never lost a fight.
That's right. He made that a point yesterday. And also, we need to point out that he defeated the Cuban, quarterfinals. And he was the first American, I think, in about 20 years that defeated a Cuban in international Olympic boxing.
You know what? I think we're talking too much about amateur prize fighting here.
There it is. Come on, go.
Perhaps. A lot of guys have great amateur records. This is the professional world.
They're trading again, and amateurs don't do this. Larry's right. This is pro boxing, and it's different. Mayweather's trying to become the first to knock DeMarcus Corley out, and he's getting a lot of free shots at him. Corley just pawing to land those punches. No impact at all. They won't help him. He's not winning rounds.
No, Mayweather's landing the effective punches.
More body shots from Mayweather. Hard right hand. Corley catching this stuff flush. Hanging in a courageous performance. Mayweather gets in a blistering left-hand shot just after the bell.
Is dead tired.
Keep going. Stay close.
Keep breaking him down.
Stay close to him. Don't pull away. Put your head up. Keep going.
This has been an overwhelming, comprehensive performance by Mayweather against a tough journeyman, hanging in there, trying to survive, make it through a couple of more rounds.
Does it tempt you to join USA Today in placing Mayweather ahead of Hopkins as number one on the pound-for-pound list?
When you defend a middleweight championship 17 times and you're still going at it, that speaks for itself.
Harold, how do you have it through 10?
He is the heir apparent. His time will come.
Harold, how do you have it through 10?
Okay, Jim. 10 rounds to nothing, 188, Floyd Mayweather Jr. Jim, I gotta tell you, you gotta give him an extra point in the 10th round, you gotta give him an extra point in the 8th round. That accounts for the 2 extra points from Mayweather. He's doing everything possible except knocking the guy out. I mean, beautiful defense, beautiful straight right hands, and a darn good left hook.
Emmanuel Stewart, between rounds, I believe New Jersey State Athletic Commission Executive Director Larry Hazard asked the Corley's corner if they didn't want to call it a night, and they resisted.
The thing about it, he's still competitive, but it doesn't look like he's going to win the fight by a knockout, and it's just a case of how much more punishment can he take. Not that he's been hurt severely by 1-1 punch, but he's just taken a lot of excessive punishment. And the hand on point to the point, I don't see a victory. Being that he's not a big knockout puncher on top of that.
Well, sometimes, as you know, Emmanuel, a fighter can be too brave for his own good. And the accumulation of these punches can take a severe toll.
And in this particular commission here is the only commission I saw that has actually jumped up in the ring one time and stopped the fight himself.
All right, we got you.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
I think it's good sometimes. You know, sometimes maybe the referee can't make the decision. Sometimes they're inexperienced, and sometimes the quantum in themselves just won't do it under any conditions.
Well, you have to remember that the rules of engagement are if the fighter is still fighting back, you got to let him fight back.
Well, I think it was...
Isn't it tough to take watching DeMarcus Corley get painted with power punches for two more rounds? He was hit with 34 out of 50 power shots in the last round.
I think it was a fight once with a guy like Murky So-So and Prince Charles Williams, where both guys was taking so much excessive punishment that I think that I had to stop the fight himself because of both guys just taking too much punishment.
Floyd Mayweather is yelling through his mouth guard at DeMarcus Corley.
You know, and Floyd has taken some shots tonight, too. We don't ordinarily see him. His mouth is bloody. His eye is swollen. So it's an easy win, it looks like. But even easy wins in boxing aren't all that easy.
Well, surely Floyd will see all that as a badge of honor.
Well, even though he's winning the fight, he's taking a lot of punishment that may have its permanent effect on him. And maybe he thinks this is the style he wants to use as he moves up into the heavy divisions, trying to prove that he's physically strong as the guys that he's going to be fighting at junior welterweight.
Well, I'll tell you what, he wants to fight Arturo Gatti. If he came in and fought Arturo Gatti this way, you'd have some entertainment, huh?
5 seconds.
Yeah, Gatti gets hit, but Gatti can take a punch there.
Trading shots again with DeMarcus Corley as the 11th round comes to a close. We got three more minutes to go in Atlantic City.
Stay right here.
Stick with us following the conclusion.
How you feel?
Feel good.
Deep breath.
Let me see what's going on in his lip there. Hey, Floyd, open your mouth for a second. It's nothing serious. Open your mouth.
Don't stop punching.
That's not good.
Close your mouth open. Just breathe normal.
Give him some more water.
Just stay. No, not right now because I got this on his nose. He's strangling. Breathe through your mouth. You can pour a little bit on his chest. There you are.
Gotta go all out.
I'm a champion, Roger. That's right.
Never tired. Never tired. Tom. This is the last show. Two fighters, different skill levels.
They're not about you, man.
11 children between them, carrying out their assignments in this fight. Corley, to show what a rugged professional prize fighter is supposed to do against a virtuoso fighter at his peak.
I got you.
Floyd Mayweather Jr. fighting for the first time at 140 pounds after having become the dominant fighter at 130 and then at 135. Entering this division against a former title holder in DeMarcus Corley, looking down the road toward potential fights against Arturo Gatti, Castazu, some of the other leading lights at 140 pounds, if he can reel them in, might not be easy.
No, I think he'll do very well with those guys. It's going to be rough fights, but I think he'll beat most of them because of his natural athletic talent and speed. But he's going to have to box a little bit more. He can't try to let this be his new style of fighting. Because a lot of guys in those divisions punch a lot harder than Chop Chop.
One question is, will those bigger punchers choose to fight him? Or will they strategically give up belts rather than to try to face Floyd Mayweather, who might be a sure loss?
Oh, I don't think Sean Bay Mitchell is going to shy away from fighting.
I'm glad you mentioned that Sean Bay Mitchell would be a big threat to him. In fact, if they fought, I would have it a toss-up fight. May even possibly favor Sean Bay.
Because of Sean Bay's southpaw style?
Southpaw style. And he's used to that weight, Joe. And he's got the same speed that would equal Mayweather.
Well, then it's a fight worth talking about. Because certainly Mayweather doesn't shrink from challenges if fighters are willing to fight.
Okay.
in the tradition of Roy Jones Jr. at the peak of his career, Mayweather may well have won every round.
I gave Corley one round. Perhaps I was being generous, giving it to him for his effort. But obviously, Mayweather has completely throttled him, dominated him, but hasn't been able to discourage him.
It's one thing comparing him to Roy Jones. Roy Jones never took this kind of punishment that he's taken in this fight. Even though he won the rounds, he won without being hit.
One more time to the canvas for Corley. His seventh time there tonight as the fight finally comes to a close.
If Floyd Mayweather Jr. Could be as solid out of the ring as he is in the ring, he might achieve the stardom that he so desperately wants.
What he wants is to be the biggest attraction in the sport. What he says right now is, I'm the most talented fighter in the sport. I ought to be the best paid.
Well, then he should have been a golfer, where the guy who finishes number one gets the most money. In this game, it's the guy who puts the most behinds in the most seats that gets paid the most.
And will that crowd appeal come for Floyd if he continues to win his fights?
It's conceivable if he fights more big fights and fights this way. Never going to reach the plateau of a De La Hoya. That's a rare plateau. But he could later on in his career fight some of the top guys and be an attraction.
If he fights this way, to be crowd pleasing, could it shorten or compromise his career?
It could, but what choice does he have if he wants to be the popular fighter that he claims he should be?
King of the game.
I just heard him say, Jim, his hand hurts.
Well, he used it a lot. CompuBox numbers showed Mayweather throwing 600 punches and landing 283, and at least half of those were power shots. Corley, 150 out of 657. And he took a lot of leather. But Mayweather was moving up to 140 pounds. In his last fight at 135, fighting Philip Endo in a very offensive style, he knocked Endo out in the seventh round. Tonight that didn't happen for him.
I feel good, man. Chop, chop. Chop, chop. I do some hard shit. Chop. I feel good, man.
Compliment from Mayweather to Corley. And now let's go to ring announcer Michael Buffer with the official decision and the scores
Ladies
on this certain Mayweather win.
Here at Boardwalk Hall, Atlantic City, we go to the scorecards. Melvina Lathan scores it 119 to 107. William Boudou has it 119-108. Gail Van Ooy, 118-108, all for the winner by unanimous decision, still undefeated, Pretty Boy, Floyd Mayweather.
Unanimous decision win for Mayweather, and there are the copy box numbers I was talking about as Mayweather, dominant throughout, landed an average of better than 20 punches per round. Power shot category will also be dominated by Mayweather, largely on the basis of the straight right hand, which he landed constantly throughout the fight, ultimately landing twice as many power shots as Corley while throwing just about the same number. And now let's go to Larry Merchant in the ring with Floyd Mayweather Jr.
Thank you, Jim. Congratulations, Floyd. Did you come out feeling, moving up in weight at this level, that your speed could overcome the bigger guys?
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank God for this victory, because without him, all this wouldn't be possible. And Chop Chop was a tough opponent, and I knew coming up, I had to show my power. So, you know, I don't know if Chop Chop ever been, he'd been knocked down in his ab judo fight, but, you know, I took my time to listen to my corner. My shoulder and my right hand was hurting, so, you know, things happen in the sport of boxing.
All right, in the first four rounds, you were going toe-to-toe with him. You backed off for a while. Is that when you hurt your hand?
I had been hurt my hand in, I think it's the fourth round I hurt my hand. But a true champion fight through anything. And, you know, I just got to give thanks to God for, you know, letting me get through it.
Did he ever hurt you because he did land some solid punches early in the fight?
Well, he landed some solid punches. He a good puncher, but I wasn't hurt at all. You know, I'm in tip-top shape, in good condition, and I feel good.
Talk to us about your future. You're naming everybody except Muhammad Ali and Joe Lewis that you want to fight. But give us some realistic expectations of the guys you think you can fight in the near future.
Well, near future, like I said before, I would love for me and Arturo Gatti to fight on pay-per-view. He's an exciting fighter, I'm an exciting fighter, and I think that's a big pay-per-view fight.
From what I understand, his handlers have told me that if he beats Durin later this summer, that he wants to fight someone like Spadafora later in the year, and then perhaps you next year. What would you do in between if that scenario unfolds?
Well, I'm the mandatory to fight for the WBC 140-pound title. I proved myself over and over again. I went to 130, beat the best. I went to 35 and beat the best. Now I'm moving up to 140. Only thing Floyd Mayweather do, he want to fight the best out there.
Thank you.
Feel good, and I want to thank, you know, Damon Dash and Rockaware. Thank 50 Cent G-Unit.
Thank you very much, Floyd. Congratulations again. Jim?
All right. Thank you very much, Larry Merchant. Final comment on Floyd Mayweather Jr.'s performance, Emmanuel?
I thought it was a very entertaining performance. I was really impressed with his courage and his guts. He stood up. He fought. He didn't try to play it safe. He fought the big boys, and he fought them. He didn't box and run away from them. But nevertheless, the fact that he got hit a lot in the fight means that he could have problems, especially with a guy like Shambay Mitchell, who's got the same speed he's got, and maybe just as much or more punching power. So it's a whole new ball game he's going into now, moving up with the big boys.
There are two candidates at this moment to replace Roy Jones atop the pound-for-pound rankings. That was Mayweather's audition for the top spot in a couple of minutes. We'll be talking live with the other candidate, veteran middleweight champion Bernard Hopkins. But right now, let's look ahead to some upcoming